is just a little craft thing that I was doing this year. So here I am making some these Christmas ornaments made out of these little cedar wood pieces. So I am doing this to sort of help someone out. I have to make just a bunch of these little ornaments. They're all these really cute little round pieces of wood, and they're all different sort of irregularly shaped, different sizes. So you can see that I have already painted some of them. They come all in the natural wood color there, and I got these off of Amazon, and they came in a pack of I think like 60 or 70 pieces. So, and you see they have the little hole drilled in there so that you can put a piece of string or whatever you'd like to hang the ornament. So, just sort of winging it here. I don't really have a plan of exactly what I'm going to paint on these. I was looking online and there's a lot of cute ideas for different designs, but I think that I'm just going to do something simple because I have to do sort of a lot of them. So I already had this paint, and I figured, alright, I will paint some of them white, some of them black, some of them green, and some of them red. And some of them I would leave that pretty wood color and just do some sort of design with the wood color as the background. So I first had to paint one side and then let all of those ones dry. And here I'm just coming back after they've dried a bit. And I'm just painting the other side. Sort of pressed for time with making these ornaments. I should have started doing them a long time ago to have them ready. So I'm kind of not exactly really doing a perfect job here, but I think they'll hopefully turn out good in the end. Okay, so I'm just doing one color at a time. Acrylic paint that I'm using, and let's see, I think next I will get a little more white to do. You can see I have some of these little markers. Also, I went and found some of these painter's pens. So I'm planning to just draw a little design on each one. Not sure exactly what at this point. I think it started out as one idea and tried a couple things and didn't really work. But I just wanted to, I was thinking that I should use some sort of stencil or something like a stamp to make each one be sort of exact and close to identical, but I wasn't able to do that, so I'm going to paint something on each side of the ornament. One side is going to be sort of personalized, and the other side I will be painting just, I think, some sort of little Christmassy image with those pens. So I think I just have a few more to do in white. Cut. could use that, or I guess I could use a different color if I wanted to. So these are just going to be like a little gift for a group of people. And just a nice little thing to do. Okay, so I think I'm done with the white at this point. And I'll touch up the other side of the black one. The ornaments that I painted red also looked really, really pretty. I'm not sure if I will have any of the red ones in this video or not, but I did paint some red and some green, and the wooden ones looked really pretty too, just nice and natural. The little image on the back. I am actually using a makeup brush to paint. I didn't realize that's what it was until I already got halfway into the project. It worked really good though, so. Keep track of how many of each color. the brush with black paint without rinsing it off. Dip it right into the red. Did this video with no talking. Wasn't really sure what I wanted to say. I do like the sounds of just the painting and all of that alone. But I thought that probably you guys would prefer for me to talk in this video. I also prefer myself to watch videos where the person is speaking, so I understand that. But I do definitely think that these sounds in this video are really nice. The painting and just sort of satisfying watching the process. But I like the sounds of the little wooden pieces and the newspaper. to only use the larger pieces. I thought some of them were sort of a lot smaller, and I wouldn't be able to make as nice of a design on the smaller ones. I think those ones are too small. Those are a little larger. Using some Christmassy colors. I have gold and I have white and green and red. So this gold one you'll see is giving me a lot of trouble. It wasn't really working so well. It's like a metallic color, but it wasn't like you have to sort of shake them and prime the end, the tip of the pen. All the other colors are working really good. So I'm making just a little Christmas tree here. Just a very, very simple Christmas tree. And then I decided to use the white and just put a little bit of snow on the tree. I thought this was a really, really simple design, and it looks cute. So I put the same little tree on all of the ornaments. I thought it was pretty and easy, very quick to make so many ornaments. So this gold has just given me a lot of trouble. So that's it, just draw the little lines for the branches of the tree. Sorry, I'll be fussing with this gold one a lot in this part of the video. I don't know why it did that. I probably used that gold color the least out of all of the colors. So I don't know why it ran out so fast. But I'll just keep trying. Really do is make the Christmas tree design. But on some of the other colors, I was able to put some snowflakes with the white marker. Just looked like just little dots all around that look like snowfall. On the black and on the red, it looked really pretty. I'm sure I have some brown paint or something I could use to finish these up. See how easy that is? Each one is sort of unique. I was thinking maybe I would put some little dots on the tree to be like Christmas balls, Christmas ornaments. And I did, try to be a little fancy with the string coming through the hole there. I was trying to tie a nice little bow, but I wasn't really doing a great job with it, so decided to tie a simple knot and leave it alone. That's something someone could always change out if they wanted to. Finish adding all of the little snow details. Still have a bunch of these left unused. I didn't need as many as I had bought, so maybe next year I will start a little sooner and make some different kinds of cute little designs. You can see this is the twine that it came with. So I just cut it into little pieces. And like I said, just tied a little knot and pushed it through. And that was it. So now here I'll just continue on and try and get this gold to work. But I'll just try and decorate a few with just the plain natural wood. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed.